Distinguidas autoridades, señoras y señores. I'm speaking here today in a double capacity as rector of the University of Alcalá in Spain, as well as chair of the Academic Council of the Permanent Academic Forum for Latin America, the Caribbean, and the European Union. I will be using two of the working languages of our regions, English and Spanish, in order to emphasize the Euro-Latin American and Caribbean focus of our work and our aim in facing this initiative as a joint commitment established by universities and other academic organizations belonging to both continents. This should not be interpreted, I beg you, as an exclusion or preclusion of the dozens of European languages spoken in the EU and in America as well, and of course the hundreds of indigenous languages that constitute one of the most precious values of our cultures in Latin America and the Caribbean. It is relevant to notice, I think, that the decision to create this permanent academic forum was one of the most important results of the first academic summit we held in Santiago de Chile in January 2013, as Rector Rossell has just pointed out. We, members of universities, foundations, associations, and other organizations related to higher education, research, science, and innovation in our regions, representing 61 countries, all of us decided to coordinate all our efforts through this permanent academic forum that would give a sense of continuity to all the groups of experts which have been meeting in preparatory seminars in Paris and Lima in 2012, then at the Santiago meeting in 2013, in further seminars in 2014, in Bucharest and Guadalajara, Mexico, and this year in another preparatory meeting at the University of Alcalá, and of course now at this second academic summit. As you are probably now aware, more than 600 academics from 225 universities, research centers, and rectors, presidents of Latin America, the Caribbean, and Europe, participated in the Santiago Academic Summit in January 2013. And a similar number, about 500, have been told by the local organizers, have registered for this second summit. Seminars during these 4 years have been analogously very well attended. It goes without saying that this has always been, and I insist on this, an open initiative, now organized through the Permanent Academic Forum and its working groups, but always eager to incorporate new institutional endeavors, such as that launched last September by the representatives or presidents of the Councils of Rectors of Europe and Latin America and the Caribbean. We are trying to work together in the future in the conviction that only through joint efforts and close cooperation between all stakeholders, the objectives achieved at the Santiago Summit, and those we might get at on this occasion will be able to succeed. We also appreciate very much the support and encouragement to the conclusions of the first summit received from students' organizations, such as the Spanish CREU, which is the coordination of representatives of students in public universities in Spain, and also the European Students' Union, ESU. En nuestra última reunión del Foro Académico Permanente en Alcalá, los pasados días 13 y 14 de abril, analizamos en profundidad los objetivos fijados en Santiago de Chile y en los seminarios posteriores de Bucarest y Guadalajara, y avanzamos en la realización de propuestas en los cuatro ámbitos prioritarios definidos en Santiago, constituyendo así cuatro grupos de reflexión permanentes sobre los que giran la mayoría de las presentaciones y debates de esta segunda cumbre de hoy y mañana. Son, en primer lugar, el grupo sobre la integración de los sistemas de educación superior, que debe trabajar especialmente en diseñar propuestas para avanzar en la convergencia en el espacio intrarregional latinoamericano y caribeño, en primer término, y luego con el europeo. Para ello, necesitamos que se creen agencias de acreditación regional independientes, que nos permitan diseñar modelos y procedimientos de reconocimiento mutuo que superen la gran heterogeneidad de estudios y títulos actualmente existentes y que fomenten la movilidad. Segundo lugar, el grupo para la promoción de la integración de los sistemas de investigación científica, tecnológica e innovación, que se propone institucionalizar los intercambios entre investigadores y grupos de investigación a nivel regional y birregional, así como promover la creación de una agencia birregional de propiedad intelectual y de un fondo birregional que fomente investigaciones y proyectos de innovación conjuntos. A ello se ha referido en las anteriores intervenciones el ministro Reino Ramírez de Ecuador. Tercero, el grupo dedicado a reflexionar y hacer propuestas sobre la colaboración entre las instituciones de educación superior y sus relaciones con la sociedad y con el sector productivo. Creo que todos somos conscientes de que ese supuesto enfrentamiento entre la universidad y la empresa es algo falso y que es necesario fomentar la cultura del emprendimiento entre los estudiantes, así como los mecanismos que permitan el financiamiento de tesis doctorales e investigaciones en las grandes empresas. Finalmente, el cuarto grupo, que es el grupo dedicado a elaborar propuestas de vinculación de la comunidad académica con las políticas públicas. En este ámbito de reflexión y debate caben numerosas cuestiones de enorme trascendencia pública, sin duda entre ellas la internacionalización de nuestras instituciones de educación superior, pero también otras, como el rol que las universidades están desempeñando y pueden desempeñar aún en mayor dimensión en la sustentabilidad de nuestras sociedades, en la educación para la sostenibilidad, tal como están haciendo en otras zonas del mundo, como en Estados Unidos o en la zona de Asia Pacífico. There are obviously many other issues related to these four working groups to be discussed during this academic summit, and I am confident that we shall be able to present a final and coherent declaration to the heads of state and governments that will be meeting this week in Brussels. A declaration that might be useful for the implementation of the policies our higher education institutions and societies need in both regions. Let me put an end to these words with the expression of my deepest gratitude to all the institutions and authorities that have been sensitive to this initiative and help us. Those present here at this opening ceremony, but also others who have not been able to join us. And finally, my warmest recognition to you all participants and to the organizers of the Permanent Academic Forum, as well as, of course, to the local organizers of this academic summit for all their enthusiasm and their efforts. Many thanks. Muchas gracias.